Only on 6 this morning, the Federal Trade Commission works with law enforcement agencies around the world to stop scammers.
And they also stress that educating consumers is at the forefront of the fight against fraud. So WDSU News reporter Rosa Flores is live in the newsroom with 6 things you can do to keep from becoming a victim of fraud. Rosa, good morning.
Well, good morning. You know, part of the challenge that these law enforcement agencies face is just how fast con artists adapt to the latest and greatest technologies. How they go from calling your home phone to calling your cell phone to contacting you via email or even text message. That's why the Federal Trade Commission issues out alerts. They want to let consumers know about what they should be looking out for. Now, at the top of the list, think about wiring money like paying cash. In other words, it's almost impossible to trace cash, so don't wire money to strangers, sellers, or people who claim to be family. Also, don't respond to messages that ask for your personal or financial information, whether the message is delivered in an email, phone call, text message, or even advertisement. Also, don't play foreign lotteries. It's easy to be tempted by promises that involve large sums of money, but time and time again, you'll be asked to pay taxes, fees, or custom duties to collect a prize, and that should trigger suspicion. Also, don't agree to deposit a check from someone you don't know and then wire them money, no matter how convincing the story is. Here's the big catch, folks. You are responsible for the checks you deposit, and at the end of the day, you are responsible for your banking transactions. Also, read your bills and monthly statements regularly, on paper and online. Scammers steal account information and then run up charges under your name. Or dishonest merchants sometimes bill you for monthly membership fees that you didn't authorize. And lastly, know who you are doing business with, who you're dealing with. Try to find your seller's physical address. Don't be satisfied with a P.O. box and a phone number. Check out the company with the Better Business Bureau and with the Secretary of State. Now, a lot of viewers have emailed and called me saying that they're getting phone calls, emails, and letters regarding lotteries. Again, keep all of these things I mentioned in mind. And if you get a bad feeling about something, follow your gut. On your side, I'm Rosa Flores for WDSU News.
All right, Rose, and if you've already fallen victim, you can file a complaint with the Better Business Bureau and call the Federal Trade Commission. That number is 1-877-FTC-HELP.